Let out the author of confusion and let in the Prince of Peace. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out the works of the flesh and let in the fruit of the Spirit. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out the legion of devils and let in the Son of God. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out the proponent of death and let in the creator of life. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out the master deceiver. You're going to let in the merciful deliverer. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out that accuser. And you're going to let in the propitiation. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out the slanderer. And you're going to let in the intercessor. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out the father of lies. And you're going to let in the spirit of truth. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out the devouring, roaring lion. And you're going to let in a meek and humble lamb. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out the one who sifts as wheat. And you're going to let in the one who is the author and finisher of our faith. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out the killer, the stealer, and destroyer. And you're going to let in the giver of abundant life. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out the bondage of sin. And you're going to let in the joy of our salvation. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let out the worker of iniquity. And you're going to let in the light of the world. When you let Jesus in, you're going to let go of that thought for tomorrow. And you're going to learn the secret of contentment. And that's all I want to share with you today, that you need to let Jesus in this 2004. Oh, I don't care how bad it is in your life. Just let him in. Oftentimes when people are outside of our door, we want to get our mess straightened out before we let them in. But I'm here to tell you that Jesus didn't come to see your mess, but he came because he knows you were in a mess. And he came over 2004 years ago, come down through 42 generations, born in Bethlehem, raised up in Nazareth, tabernacle for 33 long years. But they tell me that on one Friday, they let Jesus go up to a cross on Calvary's Hill, and he stayed on the cross to the sixth to the ninth hour. He hung his head and said, "It is finished." He hung his head and died, and he was buried in a borrowed tomb and stayed there just as he said for 3 long days and 3 long nights. But they tell me somewhere between when and then that early one Sunday morning, the same Jesus, he woke up, then he sat up, then he stood up, then he stood up, then he looked up, and after he looked up, he spoke up and said, "All power is in my hand." And when you let Jesus in, you can experience the power of him. When you let Jesus in,